All right. Hope everyone's had a good week. Again, happy Friday. Tomorrow, team, 11 o'clock. If you got a partner, either a virtual partner or a physical partner, we can make it work. Also, as always, there'll be a solo version if you just want to do it yourself. But tomorrow should be fun. I think it'll be hard, but fun. I just did the little videos for tomorrow. All right, for today. Here we go. We're gonna go as fast as possible, 5 rounds. So we're kind of switching. We're gonna finish with our ab piece and we're gonna do that kind of high intensity circuit as our first piece. So we're gonna go 5 rounds as fast as possible, 10 alternating renegade rows. So just 10 renegade rows, which is that push-up into a row from the plank position. 10 push-ups, 10 rows. So you're gonna do 5 rows on each side, 10 push-ups, because each row starts with a push-up. Then we're gonna go into 5 devil's press. 5 devil's press. So that's kind of like that weighted burpee. I'll show you, I'll review those again before we start. And then we have 20 reverse lunges. So 10, 5, 20. Try to go heavy on the lunges. The renegade rows, that's a lot of core work. So kind of, it's not a ton of push-ups. It ends up being 10 push-ups, but it's really core intensive because you got to be able to stabilize in order to pull up. So play around with some weights. If you have different options, you can mess around with that a little bit before we start, but try to go heavy. It's not a lot. It says 5 rounds. It seems like a lot, but it'll go pretty quick. And especially on those lunges, if you have an extra dumbbell or extra heavy dumbbell, grab it and go heavy on those lunges. The second part, so we'll take a little breather, and then we have 4 rounds through this little ab piece. So we're gonna do 30 seconds of a hollow body hold. So it's kind of like the flipped over version of a plank. We'll show you those. There's the repost. We're gonna do 30 second hollow body hold right into 30 seconds of flutter kick. So straight legs kicking those legs up and down. And then we have these alternating dead bugs for a minute. Those are a little slower, but that's kind of where, well, I'll show you. But we got a minute of those. Then we're gonna take a 30 second rest and do it all over, 4 rounds, 4 rounds. So that'll be a good little ab piece to finish off the day. And that's it, that's it. If you have questions now or after the warm up and review, let me know. If you need any modifications for injuries or equipment or anything else, let me know. Let's do it. Let's get it going. Alright, let's start with some high knees, running in place.
like the way you talk. I like the things you wear. I want your number tattooed
on my arm
in ink, I swear. Cause when the morning comes,
other arms down behind you, stretch out the front of your shoulder, and throw your hands up and behind you to get those lats. And just to stretch out a hamstring a little from yesterday, let's just hang down a little five times. Hang down to the toes. And then open it up. We'll do five of those. Stretch out those hamstrings if you're sore from those deadlifts yesterday.
Tattooed on my arm in ink, I swear. Cause when the morning comes, I know you won't
one
be
more.
But every time I turn around, you dance.
All right, let's head to the floor. Arms out to the side. We need those scorpions. So arms out to the side. You're gonna bring one heel up and over. And then switch. Back and forth. Try to keep that shoulder flat on the floor. Bring your heel up and over as far as you can. One more on each side. All right, last one. We're just gonna go from the top of a push-up. And I just want you to step in and out of lunges. So just nice deep lunge, hold for a couple seconds and switch. Hold for a couple seconds, lean into it and switch. One more on each side. Good big lunge step. Lean into it a little bit. Last one. Okay, let's talk about these movements. All right. So first couple things. We got renegade rows. We have devil's press and reverse lunges. Renegade rows. I'll show you an option if you have dumbbells. If you have some object, I will show you what we're gonna do instead. So for renegade rows, you're gonna do your push-up on your dumbbells, okay? I'll do it this way. Push-up on your dumbbells. You can widen your feet a little bit so they're out a little bit for a more solid base. We're gonna do a push-up. At the top of that push-up, we're gonna row. Push-up. Into a row. Push up, row. 10 total, five each side, but each one is a push up. So it's 10 push ups, five and five, alternating through. Those are renegade rows. If you have an odd object or one dumbbell, we're gonna do 10 push ups and 10 bent over rows. Bent over rows, which we've done before. So if you have one thing, you're gonna bend over and give me your rows here for 10. If you can, go heavy and go slow if you're doing bent over rows. It's a little bit easier and you should be a little bit stronger doing the bent over row than you are the renegade row. So if you can, go a little heavier on those rows. 10 good push-ups and then stand up and give me those bent over rows, 10 and 10. 10 and 10. Those are the renegade rows. Next, you have devil's press. You're gonna still hold onto your dumbbells. You're gonna put them on the floor. Do a burpee, so all the way down. J jump up. We're swinging those weights up overhead. Now, jump up, swing those weights overhead. Those are renegade, or those are devil's press. If you have a sandbag, you can just kind of lay down on that sandbag, hop up and swing it up. If you have one dumbbell, just put that dumbbell out in front of you, give me a burpee, jump up, and swing. They're kind of like a burpee into a swing. That's fine too. So those are devil's press. And then we're going into reverse lunges. If you're gonna stay with two dumbbells, which try to stay with two dumbbells, so it's a little heavier, and you're just stepping back into that lunge, tap that back knee, and stand. Remember our lunges, we want a lot of right angles, a lot of 90 degree angles. So when I'm down here, everything's in a straight line here, so I got close to 90 degrees in that back leg, meaning I'm not too far forward and I'm definitely not way too far back, but I'm just straight up and down, knee, hip, shoulder. And that front knee is at 90. So again, not a huge step out, not a short step. We're just nice 90 degree angles, standing up. That's gonna protect those knees. Those are reverse lunges. 20, go heavy on the lunges if you can. Abs, second part. So we got hollow body holds, flutter kicks, and dead bugs. For the hollow body hold, we want to drive our lower back into the floor. So the best way to get into this position is to start here. Hold your knees. So from this position, I can feel only my lower back is on the floor, not my butt, not my shoulders, but just my low back. Now I'm going to let go, keep that position. I can just feel my abs engage. So once you let go of your knees, you'll feel those abs start to engage. If this is all you can do, you're holding here. If you're able, extend out, still driving that lower back into the floor, still keeping your butt and your shoulders off, and get as tall or as long as you can, and hold. Flutter kicks. You can support your low back by putting your hands right under your butt. Straight legs, little 6 to 12 inch kicks. Boom, 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 for 30 seconds. Dead bugs. Knees up at 90. Hands and fingers pointing straight up to the sky. You're gonna straighten one leg and the opposite arm. And back. Opposite and back. Opposite and back. Same thing we talked about for those hollow body holds. We want our shoulders off. We want that lower back driving into the floor. And we're just alternating. Boom. Boom. For a minute. You can go as fast or as slow as you're able to go. But those shoulders are staying up. So we're not just lying down on the floor completely relaxed and doing it, or engaged the whole time. I think that's it. I think that's it. So what do we need? Front rack, farm. You can do whatever you want on those lunges, yeah. First day doesn't matter. You can hold them down, you can hold them up, you can set them on the shoulders. I think I'll probably try to just set them up here on the shoulders. But you can do whatever you'd like for holding those dumbbells on your lunges. Anything else? Nada? Okay. We are going to do a 10-minute cutoff on the first part. That gives you 2 minutes around. Are we going to do that? Yeah, 10 minutes. You guys will make it. 10 minutes. Gotta move. Gotta move. Okay. One of these movements of the three, you got your rows, devil's press, and lunges, should feel good. You'll be good at one of those. On that one, move quick. Move quick. If you're not great at some of the other ones, you can slow it down, pace it a little bit, but the one you feel good, strong at, crank them out. All right, let's get it going. Let's get it going. Remember on those renegade rows, you gotta focus on your abs.
gotta focus on that core strength. Gotta be stable and not moving all over. So think about abs first before you row. Let's do it. 10 seconds, we got renegade rows for 10, we got devil's press for 5, and we got reverse lunges for 20. 5 rounds. Here we go, starting in 10 seconds.
Come on. running and running, running and running, running.
Woo! Keep going. We got 2.5 minutes to go.
These are my friends. She grabbed my face and that's when she said, I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool.
Oh. Man, come on, 20 seconds. Finish your 5 rounds or just work straight through 10 minutes. Come on. 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Woo! Man. Alright. That got me. Alright, catch your breath. Catch your breath. I'll take another minute or so. Oh. And then we just got our abs. Ab piece. Whew, that was the hard part. Now we just have some easy abs. Man. Oh. Well, that was fun. Okay, so this next part, we have 4 rounds. It's 2 minutes of work, 30 seconds of rest. Right? We got the abs to look forward to. Now we got that thing out of the way. So we got 2 minutes of work, 30 seconds of rest, and do what you can. Do what you can. Those alternating dead bugs, even though it's a minute, those should not, it's only the final movement, but it won't kill you. If you need to slow down, slow down there. The biggest thing on all of these is that we're in just an active position. So imagine that plank hold, right? Where we're in a plank is pretty active. We're just flipping it over onto our back, but it's still almost that same active position. So the first one, that hollow body hold, we're not doing anything. It's static, but we're holding in that active position. The flutter kicks, we're still holding in that active position, but now we're fluttering our legs. Those dead bugs, we're holding in that active position, but now we're alternating, extending arms and legs. So that active position is constant through the whole thing. It's driving your lower back into the floor by flexing those abs. And then we'll take a 30 second rest. Whew. All right. This watch said my heart rate got up to 164, which is pretty dang high. And now it's down to 110. So I think we can go. I'll let you know where we're at. I'll let you know where we're at. We're gonna start with that hollow body hold. Remember, get as much of your body on all of these, as much of your body off the ground as possible. That means your shoulder blades are off the ground. Your upper and mid back are up off the ground. It's just your low back and the top of your butt. Legs are off, your butt's off, other than that little space, about 4 inches of your upper butt and lower back. That's all that we want on the floor. Cool? And that goes for all of those movements. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Broken pieces, one at a time. Seconds, we got 30 seconds to hold here. Try to start from this position. Feel your abs engaged when you let go. And let's do it. Bend a little. Almost like you're just about to start a crunch. Shoulder blades up, butt is up. Just got that lower back, top of your butt on the floor. 10 seconds. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll Three, two, one. Flutter kicks. Shoulder blades off. Just fluttering those legs. Keep moving your legs. If your abs are burning, you can lower the upper body a little bit. Three, two, one. Alternating dead bugs. These last two rounds. I'm halfway there. All right, 10 seconds back into that hollow body position, just a static hold with those abs tight. And three, two, one, here we go.
Just
Three, two, one. Butter kicks. Butter kicks. Alternating dead bugs. Whew. Last one, then we'll rest.
They brag a man has walked in space, but you can't even find my place. There ain't nothing you can do.
Tight abs and hold. Last 30 seconds. Last round was rough. Rough. All right. Awesome work. Everyone's abs feeling fired up. Whew. All right. Awesome job. Awesome week. See you guys tomorrow at 11. That's it. Last day of July. Already in the end of August. Whew. Don't forget, you can go to the website for any merch if you want it. Check it out. You can subscribe on there. YouTube link is on there if you want those. All that good stuff. Endorphins.com is that site. Thank you, guys. Have a good rest of your Friday. Do something fun.
Thanks, Charlie.
Thank you. Thanks, Charlie.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
Thanks, Charlie.
Oh, yeah.